Week 2, lighting of the second candle. This Sunday, we remember that God has promised to bring peace to the world. During this season of Advent, we prepare our hearts to receive the gift of God's Son, Jesus Christ. And in Him, we are given a peace that passes all understanding.
Today, our world is deeply divided by fear and violence, and we are afflicted with suffering of all kinds. Yet Jesus, so named because he would save his people from their sins, gives us hope. He promised to come again and bring healing to our broken world. As God's children, we are invited to be at peace with ourselves, with others, and with God. And so, we light this candle to remind us that peace has come to the world through our Lord Jesus Christ.
Listen to the words of Isaiah, the prophet. The people walk in darkness have seen a great light. On those living in the land of deep darkness, a light has dawned. For to us a child is born, to us a son is given, and the government will be on his shoulders, and he will be called Wonderful Counselor, Mighty God, Everlasting Father, Prince of Peace.
Let us pray. Heavenly Father, thank you for the gift of your Son, Jesus. We pray that you would bring peace and healing into our broken world. In the name of Jesus Christ, the Peace of Prince, the Prince of Peace, we pray. Amen.
Amen. This is such an exciting Sunday. We have been waiting since September for the Camargo family to join us. So Paulo and Tati, you're going to come up, and you can get positioned up here to lead worship. And Ryan and Philip, would you come and just stand up here so everybody can see you? Right up front. So I want you to look at everybody and wave. This is your new church family. I want you to look at those people online. Look right at that red dot on the camera and wave. And come on, let's go. Okay, you guys. No, that's a dot.
Good morning, church. Normally I do this, I said good morning. For most of you that don't know my face, I will show right now. It's incredible, with mask or not, know me. I hope you have a great moment to worship the Lord this morning. We are here because of Him, because of Jesus. And He is the one that this. He's the one that we are praising this morning. It's an honor to be worshiping Him. So, I just want to read one verse with you. You don't need to open the Bible right now. But, my soul will rejoice in the Lord and delight in His salvation. Jesus brings us the salvation into our lives. He brings light into the darkness. Let's stand and worship Him this morning. so grateful. And this is the Sunday of Advent, and we are pointing to Jesus. Let's rejoice and sing the song, It's Christmas. Thank you.
people that you came to earth, Lord, to reach down to us. And Father, we want to thank you this morning that our hope is in you. Amen?
Amen.
Father, our hope is in you. We want to pray in a special way for doctors and nurses and people who are working so hard in hospitals and other places during this time of pandemic. Father, we pray for the scientists, the people working on the distribution of this vaccine. Father, we pray that things would go well, that things would go safely. Father, we pray for a quick resolution to this challenge. Father, that you would be working through each and every one of these situations, each and every one of these people. But Father, we remind ourselves today, Father, we remind ourselves that our hope is in you. Father, it's so good to be with your people. It's so good to worship you this morning. We ask that you would bless us. We pray for those, even in our own congregation, who are suffering a loss of jobs. People, even if it is not COVID-related, Father, we thank you for how you have kept us through this time. But we pray for those who are suffering illness, some of whom online right now in this time. Father, we pray that you would be with them. Father, that you would be with the caretakers and people who love them, who surround them, that your presence would be manifest in their living rooms this morning when they watch online. Father, we pray for family members that we know that need a touch from you. Lord, I pray for people that I know, and we pray for people that we know who are recovering from COVID. Father, we pray that your presence would be with them in this time, that your healing power would be manifest in them. But most importantly, Lord, we thank you again for your presence with us. Lord, that you have not left us as orphans. Father, you have loved us. And Lord, you have shown us your love by sending us your Son. And Father, we are so grateful for that. We worship you this morning in Jesus' name. Amen. Amen.
Oh,
you have a need right now, you're a member of this church in any way, please let us know. We are here to help you, to help each other, and to honor Jesus. Amen?
Amen.
So bring your offering.
Good morning, church.
Good morning.
But for those who know our journey, to be here in this country again, now in this church, is a gift from God for us. And our family is very grateful to God for the housing we live in today, for being with you, and for Pastor Doug and his family, and for being part of God's plan here on the earth. We have many testimonies of God's provision, the manifestation of His power and His grace, but we chose part of history to share with you this morning. And that no matter how difficult times you are facing, we are facing, Jesus is our hope. And Jesus is our peace for everything. And I will start for, this is our timeline.
Who's that?
In 2004, we started a date. And after Paulo asked me, if one day I would move to the United States with him, and I said, of course, I will be married with you, I will. And so in 2007, we got married. In 2008 until the end of 2010, we had financial problems because we had lost our jobs, and both. Well, it was a very difficult time. But in this time, it was during this time, we had a deep relationship with God. And this time, we read the book, The Purpose Driven Life, by Rick Warren, and we discovered that we are unique, and God shaped us and formed us with a purpose in this planet. It seems simple and obvious, but we were in our room, and the Holy Spirit, the first time, filled us. In this difficult time, that prophecy began to come, especially for Paul, about him being a pastor. In 2010, then I got a job. So far from my house, my salary was 3 times less than my other less salary. And with 6 months of company, I got pregnant. Of course, wasn't planning, but God sent Ryan to us. Even though I was pregnant, I did my best to the company. And the owner of the company tripled my salary during my pregnancy. And after Ryan was born, I was responsible for the company. Financials, accounts, employees. I opened and closed the company. And this time, I made a lot of money. And at the same time, Paul got a great job too, with a great salary. It's the fourth slide. Yes, this picture. Anyway, it was a great financial moment in your marriage. We paid our bills, we saved the money, and we also started a dream again. And Orion was born in the end of the November 2010, and he has brought us many blessings. Kids bring us blessings. And we are very grateful to the companies we work for. But there came a time when I was very tired and was feeling guilt because I worked a lot and didn't time for Ryan, for my family, and especially God. I was like a workaholic. And everything was suffocating me and making me uncomfortable. And Paulo feeling the same thing in his job. And Paulo asked me, Tati, are you leaving for the United States? I think this time is now. We started to pray for this purpose. And this time we had other prophecies. In March 2013, we arrived in Florida. And when we got there, immigration room, we had a test of faith in immigration room. Some prophecies started to be fulfilled. But we are not going to talk about this today because it is a long story. Another day we tell this testimony. But it's a long history of miracles and angels in immigration room. So, God is good all the time. And if you are not enjoying today of goodness of God today, in the life you are living today, know that He's good. And He cares for you and your whole family. While you sleep, He works. Never forget this. In Florida, we had a wonderful time. The pastor, Florida is Florida. Beach is an amazing place. And we have a wonderful time. And the pastor, Dalzira, is a Brazilian pastor. And Joseph, and your husband, from the Free Methodist Church, help us a lot. We praise God for their lives, our angels that God sent us. And was in Florida that God confirmed our call. And then Philip was born in 2000. Another blessing that God sent. This was the first part of our story in a very summarized way. For you to know us a little more and what God has done in your lives and is still doing. I will now share with you quickly the ministry journey to this day. Florida, we started to help Free Methodist Church, South Florida, a small church, but we have many people praying, a lot of people praying. And in an apartment, there were Bible studies with women. And we also started to small groups and the new members, home from church. It's a very good time. This pastor is another angel that God gave us. It was she who gave me the idea to teach him piano lessons. And brought me the first students all from her church. And then I never stopped to teach. And here was the second piano recital. It's the picture. In her church, this is a Brazilian church of friends. And Paulo also helped the worship team in some service there. Paulo started helping the worship team, a big church, the Church by the Glades, is a big church in Florida. And I help the guest service with a coffee bar. It was a very good experience. Also in Florida, we had a an ancient church, a church full of power of God, full of the Holy Spirit, loving simple people in the worships of God. It's a very difficult to say goodbye for them. It's a very good people. Here, you know them? Here we have already started a new moment. After Pastor Dalzia from Florida told for Pastor Jensen and Vivian about us, they introduced us for Pastor Dan and talking about the need help the Bethel Church in Fort Worcester. And we left the Florida and we came for here. So we went to Bethel Church in Fort Worcester. My hair is very different. Serving this church and serving God through this church, and they're grateful to God to opportunity to help this beloved church. Is that? And in the same time, you guys, we had assembly times in Alexandria Church, and since then we love this church.
This is my
backyard. Yes, your backyard. It's true. This was a very important day. Paulo was received as a ministry candidate in the United States. And on this day, he was without tie and blazer. So Pastor Mila, when saw him, said for him, Paulo, you need a tie and a blazer. They will call soon. And the Pastor Miller's mother took a tie from Pastor Miller's father. And Pastor Jensen gave his blazer. And now Paulo was ready for... This is Paulo. Okay, this is timing. This was one of the most difficult moments we faced. Return to Brazil in 2016. Many questions and difficult moments we face. The return to Brazil brought us at the first sadness and discouragement. However, God was taking care and getting people to talk to us. Because God is good, God's care. God is everything for us. If you are going through a difficult time, don't give up. Don't get distracted. Stay firm, stay strong. Look at Jesus. He takes care and He will not abandon you. Amen. And then we arrive in Brazil. And God's words continue. When we arrived in Brazil, all of us, we got sick, especially the kids, with a breathing problems. Felipe has a problem in his ear, and because of this, he has a speech delay. But God cares for him. And we don't stop. We start help the church in São Paulo City, this big church. But when we arrived, God also provide a private pediatrician for the children, free. And scholarship for them, for study a great Christian school. This is a beautiful testimony that one day I will tell you. But I invite you for coming Fridays, because over there we talking about our histories. In this church, Paulo's parents got married. Paulo and I got married in this church. And both, we also received the ministry candidate by our bishop. In Brazil, we have many stories, but God's provision. Yeah, it's, in 2017, we are sent to help for revitalize a Free Methodist church that had experienced many leadership problems. The church had 150 members, and when we arrived there were 20 members. All the worship team left this church. And we started the working for this church. There we did it. Paulo talked to teenagers, Paulo preaches a lot to them, and we work with the worship again. And we start at the church. We stayed in the church for the 1 year and 8 months, and went out to help another church for revitalize too. Because of this, another church also divided because of the bad leadership. And it's another church we helped in 2018. We arrived in this church, also was so far from our house, and we are also starting the revitalization work at the Sunday school, choir, worship team, other ministries in the church. 2018 was a very difficult year for us. Several family members died, including my father. And return to Brazil was special and necessary, because my father could meet Philip and was able to say goodbye for him. And God is good all the time. And we have a small church and covering that. This is a congregation. A small church in the middle of the mountains. It's a beautiful place. And after almost 3 years in Brazil, one day I was leaving the school where I worked and the children were studying. I got a call from Pastor Miller saying, "Tati, pack your bags. Your visa was approved." I was in the car and I cried a lot. When I remember this time, I cried. I called Paulo, and we were very happy and thankful. It was a blessed day. And glorify God and praise Him. And when we arrived in May 2019, the conference sent us to live at the campground house. Amazing place, the campground house. And help for a special church. The special church too. We have a good times there. And now, God has brought us here again. God is amazing. And our desire is to serve to the Lord with all our hearts. From the beginning, we had many changes, many trials and tests of faith. But God always was with us. Paulo did continue for this.
What a journey. Now I'm going to tell the story again. The true story. Yes, God is good. We understand that God has bigger plans for all of us. Sometimes it's not easy to understand. But he is doing his work. If you have a humble heart, patience, and asking the Holy Spirit to show you, you're going to understand this. Yeah. I want to just say, you remember in John 15, verse 1, that passage that talks about the branch, and any branch in me that does not bear fruit, that stops bearing, he cuts away. Trims off, takes away. And he cleanses and repeatedly prunes every branch that continues to bear fruit. To make it bear more and richer and more excellent fruit. This passage is not just me speaking, or Pastor Doug, or any apostle. It was Jesus. So there's deeply understanding here. Sometimes we are facing moments in our lives that looks like we don't feel God in our lives, right? Or maybe we are facing, we lost a job that we really love, or something else, or a relationship, or you can have any experience here, but sometimes it's God doing the pruning. And God is doing the work. So our history was about this. Sometimes God take you out from the comfort zone, shake you, and just go. And he is developing in you and me faith. Even if you don't see him. Sometimes we don't see him, we don't feel it. But he's teaching us faith. Because faith, he says in the Bible that he enjoys faith. He loves when we get a step of faith in our life. Amen?
Amen.
And yes, pruning is basically means to trim. To trim away wild branches and get something back into shape. To trim off the useless branches that are not bearing fruit or dead branches. So, you see where I'm going? Sometimes you need to feel some pain to bear fruit. I know it sounds like, I don't want to feel pain in my life, but it's a different pain. When you face pain in your life with faith, it's totally different. You don't have fear anymore because you know you are stepping in the solid ground in Jesus. Fear has lost its grip on me. Amen?
Amen.
And, Every Christian wants to give good fruits, right? And if you're expecting your life being fruitful, I'll tell you, you need to expect being pruned. It hurts. I'll tell you, it hurts. But keep your faith. And in the meantime, you're going to find out you're giving good fruit to your family, to your friends, to your co-workers. You are showing love to people, and you're just standing in the solid ground. You are like a tree with deep roots. Outside, you could be showing just like the winter season trees, like that one. We can see and say, oh, it's dead, that tree is dead. No. People only see outside, but God sees inside. Amen? The tree is there because she has great and deep roots. Amen? So if you want to bear fruit, good fruit, spiritual fruit, expect to be pruned. And in this time of Advent, it's so special. I want to say that Jesus, Emmanuel, God with us, we are celebrating Him. We are looking at the birth of Jesus with hope. Hope. Jesus brings hope into our lives, into our darkness, days. Jesus brings light into our lives. And hope means we need to be, we need to be looking into our lives and asking God to clean us, to the Holy Spirit show in our life what we need to do, what we need to change. Because if we just come to the church and sing beautiful songs, but as soon as we step out, we don't have change in our hearts, how the Holy Spirit is going to use you? Remember, we are in this journey to be changed by the Holy Spirit, not by the pastor, not by me, not by anybody, by God. And this is beautiful. He does this in miracle ways. You're going to cry before the Lord when you see something miracle happening in your life. And yes, Jesus is our hope. And He brings peace into our house, to this church, into your life. The thief comes only to steal and kill and destroy. Yes, there is an enemy outside. Don't forget this. But the enemy, he has no power before the Lord Jesus. Jesus said like this, I have come that they may have life. He is our hope. He is bringing peace to you and me. And have it to the full. Amen? He is our peace. He wants to give you peace. It's not the peace the world is showing to you. Money can bring peace? No. It's going to bring you just distraction. You can travel for a beautiful hotel and be treated like a king. But this is not peace. The real peace is deep inside of your heart that only God shows. Because that's what Jesus is saying here. He's coming to bring us life. And not just life, just his life to the full. We are free because of Jesus. He is our hope. He is our peace. And in this morning, we are celebrating this peace we have in Jesus. Amen? He was almost everything we had to say today. And yes, open your heart. It's the season, this season of the Advent is a season to open your heart before the Lord. Not just today, tomorrow, every day. And ask the Holy Spirit to show what parts in your heart there are hiding, you're hiding. You can't be hiding before the Lord. And honestly, try to open your heart sincerely, right? Because he knows you, he knows your heart, and he's expecting you to speak the truth you're feeling. And sometimes it's not just the beautiful words, sometimes it's the sad words, yes. But when you start this lament, confession. And when confession comes, you start to feel the peace of God in your life. That only the Holy Spirit can do it. And this is amazing. This is why we are here this morning, to celebrate Jesus, to point everything to Jesus, because he is our hope and he is our peace. Hallelujah. In Jesus' name, I call Pastor to finish this moment. Thank you for your patience. We are so glad to be here to serve the Lord Jesus with you. I heard a lot of histories about this church. This church has a great heart to serve. And we are here to learn with you. Sometimes you are here just to teach us. No, we are here to help and to learn with you. Because Jesus is doing his work in this church, in this community, in your families. Amen?
Amen.
It is wonderful that we're going to end this time by celebrating communion together, right? This is the time to open your heart to Jesus in a new way. Just a couple of things. I'll start with the silliest part. The first picture you showed of you and Tati dating, you looked like you were 13 years old.
10 years ago.
Yeah.
10 years ago. Did you have the earring back? Did you have the earring back?
Oh, yeah, I have that.
Yeah, so I have to zoom in on that. We are blessed to have you here in our church. You guys are precious to our hearts already. In the New Testament, there was a pastoral ministry team called Priscilla and Aquila. It was a husband and wife ministry team that God used to start churches throughout all over the Mediterranean basin. And you guys are like a modern day Priscilla and Aquila. We're so glad that you're here. I have a feeling, I already feel this already, I kind of want to staple your suitcase to the ground for a while. And God has a purpose for you here, and God has a purpose for what he wants to do in our church while you guys are here. Paulo is a CMC still? You don't know what that means, but he knows, yeah. So still, we have a different designations heading towards full ordination, even though you've passed our churches and done all kinds of things. We do not limit in our denomination what God can do through persons. And so you will be fully ordained this summer, hopefully at a large event, amen, in Southeast Pennsylvania. So that's going to be exciting, but not only Paulo, also Tachi is going to be fully ordained. So Paulo is going to help us with communion. Tachi's also going to help us. She doesn't know this, but if you're going to be a pastor, you always have to be ready. So what we are going to do is you're going to do the Lord's Prayer, and you're going to do it in Portuguese. Amen? So we can hear that. Come up. Come on. One on each side. You could. I'm going to put on this mask and a glove too. This is the Lord's invitation to us. You who truly and earnestly, I love that word, earnestly, repent of your sins, who live in love and peace with your neighbors, and who intend to lead a new life, following the commandments of God and walking in his holy ways, draw near with faith and take this holy sacrament to your comfort, and humbly kneeling, make your honest confession.
Our Father, which art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done in earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our debts, as we forgive our debtors. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory forever.
Pai nosso que estás nos céus, santificado seja o teu nome. Venha a nós o teu reino. Seja feita a tua vontade, assim na terra como nos céus. O pão nosso de cada dia nos dai hoje. Perdoa as nossas dívidas, assim como nós perdoamos os nossos devedores. E não nos deixes cair em tentação, mas livra-nos do mal, pois teu é o reino, o poder e a glória para sempre. Amém.
On the night of his betrayal, Jesus took bread, and when he had given thanks, he broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, take and eat. This is my body, which is given for you. Do this in remembrance of me. In like manner, after supper, he took the cup, and he gave thanks again, and he gave it to them, saying, drink of this, all of you, for this is my blood of the New Testament, which is shed for you and for many for the remission of sins. Do this as often as you drink it in remembrance of me. The communion is available in the center aisle. If you would be careful as you come to take a cup and go back to your seats. And I'd ask if you would withhold partaking of the elements till everybody has been served and we'll partake together. So the table is open. body and the blood of our Lord Jesus Christ.
Por tu cuerpo en la sangre de Jesús.
Amén. Let's partake together. Worship team.
we love you. We ask your Holy Spirit to keep your work, to heal our hearts, Lord. We give all the honor because you deserve. You are holy. You are great. You are full in love. You are full in mercy. Thank you, Jesus, for your word, for all your passion. In Jesus' name I pray, amen.
Father, bless us as we leave this place today. Father, we have been blessed. Blessed. Father, we thank you for this story of Jesus that we have heard. And Father, we leave this place this afternoon taking the story of Jesus with us. Father, send us forth in the power of your Holy Spirit to bring hope in a world that is feeling hopeless. Lord, to bring courage when there is so much fear. Lord, to bring wisdom in the face of foolishness. Father, send us forth in the presence of